Welcome to audio video system playlist. I, Professor Ritesh Dholakia, is going to explain you three color theory in this session. So to understand this session based on three color theories, I'll be explaining additive and subtractive mixing in this session along with this session outline.
So first I'll explain approximate relative response of I to different colors. So we will see how I responds to different colors. Then I'll explain you different types of mixing of colors, where first I'll explain additive mixing of color and secondly I'll explain you subtractive mixing of colors. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is approximate relative response of I to the different colors. Now see, this is what I'll explain you one graph so it will be more clear. So on y-axis, that is relative sensitivity of the eye, and that is from 100% to 0% over here. And here different wavelengths are there in nanometer, and as you know, different colors are spreaded from 4000 angstrom to 8000 angstrom. So that is the region which I have considered. So you can see from here 350 nanometer means 3500 angstrom wavelength, right? And this is where here you have 750 nanometer wavelength. You can observe this graph, right? So this is how our eye is having sensitivity. So over here highest sensitivity is there with eye, means one can say 100% sensitivity means highest. So that is there with green color at 550 nanometer wavelength, right? And as you move away from 550 nanometer wavelength, sensitivity of color for eye will decrease. You can see that. So towards red color as well as towards violet color, it will be minimum. And beyond that, our eye cannot sense any color. So as we know, we can see only visible spectrum ranging from 4000 angstrom to 8000 angstrom, right? So that is there in this range, which is what we can sense by our eyes. So highest sensitivity, that is there with green color, and with red color it is least, and with violet color is even it is least, right? And that is how it is decaying. You can see that by this graph. Now based on this sensitivity, we can generate multiple colors, and to understand that we need to understand different types of mixing of color. So now I'll explain you types of mixing of color. So there are basically two types: additive mixing of color and subtractive mixing of colors. So when we talk about additive mixing of color, in that we are dealing with to add different colors, right? So that I'll show you by some cases so it will be more clear. See, in additive mixing of color, it is forming a color based on mixing of two or more colors, and that can be from independent light sources, right? And after mixing, it is resulting into one color, and that is what we are sensing as a different color. So in additive mixing, we mix two different colors and our eyes is sensing that as a different color. And here you'll be finding we can obtain so many colors by mixing pure colors. Here we are not dealing with to subtract color, here we will be adding colors. And by addition of different colors, it is possible to generate white color in additive mixing. So I'll show you that so it will be more clear. See, in additive mixing, there are three major colors. One can say those are primary colors, and those are red, green and blue. And by mixing these three colors, red, green and blue, we can adjust intensity to create most number of colors, right? So by adding with different proportion of intensity, we can create different colors. And I'll show you some colors even in additive mixing. See, impression of white light also can be created by choosing suitable intensity of these three colors, and that is referred as luminance. So luminance, that is what additive mixing of these three colors, red, green and blue. So I'll show you that in colors, so it will be more clear. So in additive mixing, ultimately we mix multiple colors to generate resultant color, and that is what additive. There is no subtraction of white color. So let us see that by color, so it will be more clear. Here one can see this is red, blue and green colors, right? So these are primary colors, red, green and blue. Now when you add red and green color, it will generate yellow color. You can see it over here. When you add green and blue, that will generate cyan color. You can see it over here, right? And when you add red and blue, that will generate magenta color. You can see it over here, right? So this is how we can generate different colors. And this is what we can generate by having some proportion. So let us try to understand this proportion. And that one can understand by this formula, which is what? White color. So when you add 0.3 into R plus 0.59 into G plus 0.11 into B. Here R is red, J is green and B is blue. So when you add these colors in this proportion, it will generate white color. So we can say here this R, that is 0.3 over here. This G, that is 0.59 over here. This B, that is 0.11 over here, right? So when you add these two color, R and G, by some proportion, it will be generating yellow color over here. So here yellow color, that is having proportion which is 0.89, right? So here it will be 0.89. When you add G and B, that will generate cyan color. So when you add this G, that is 0.59, and this B, that is 0.11, it will generate cyan, that is 0.7. And when you add red and blue, it will generate magenta color over here. And that proportion, that will be 0.3 plus 0.11, that will be 0.41 over here. So that is how different colors are getting added. And when you add red with 0.3, green with 0.59 and blue with 0.11 together, it will generate white color in additive mixing. You can see it over here. So this is what additive mixing of colors, and that is what generating different colors by mixing three primary colors. Let us see subtractive mixing, so it will be more clear, like what exactly the case which we do to generate different colors. So in subtractive mixing, we will be subtracting colors from white color. So see, in subtractive mixing, reflecting properties of pigments are used, and which will absorb all wavelengths from their color characteristics. So in subtractive mixing, we use reflecting properties of pigments, right? So here we are dealing with to subtract colors from white color, and we can generate any other color by having reflecting properties. So when pigments of two or more colors are mixed, they reflect the wavelengths and which are common to the both. So you'll be finding when you mix two color by having subtractive mixing, all it will be doing is it will be reflecting those colors which are common for the both, and that will be the resultant color, right? So since pigments are not quite saturated over here, it will be pure color, right? Saturated means pure color. So pigments are not saturated color, so they fairly reflects wide wavelengths. So you'll be finding resultant color, that is what we are generating by having subtractive mixing. Now see, in subtractive mixing, if you subtract from three major colors, you will be finding black color is there, as saturated color is not quite sure. So white color will get eliminated, and at the end you'll be finding black color by proper proportion of subtraction of three different colors, R, G and B. While in case of additive mixing, you will be finding that addition of three different color will result into white color, while in case of subtractive mixing, because of subtraction of white color has been happening, white color will get nullified and it will be resulting into black color. Where here on subtractive mixing, we will be using reflective properties. That's why that is happening. So I'll show you how that is happening. See, this type of mixing will take place in painting and in color printing, right? So we use this subtractive mixing in painting and in color printing. So let us see this subtractive mixing. You can see over here, subtractive mixing is been done, where this is red, green, blue, magenta, cyan, yellow, and subtractive mixing is resulting into black color over here. But how it is getting generated? So you just see this R that is getting generated by subtraction of white color from this GNB. So if you subtract GNB from white color, that will result into R, means red color. If you subtract GNR from white color, it will generate blue color. If you subtract R and B from white color, it will generate green color, right? Now see, for yellow, all you need to do is, you just need to subtract blue color from white, it will generate yellow. If you subtract red color from white, it will generate cyan. And when you subtract green color from the white color, it will generate magenta color. See, that is how subtractive mixing is happening. So here, reflective properties are being used. So when you subtract these three colors from white color, RGB, it will be generating black color. While in additive mixing, it will be generating white color. See, this is what the difference which is there in between additive mixing and subtractive mixing.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is, I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel so that students can easily learn everything which is required in the university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topic which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions, which is highly required here to optimize this channel.